안녕하세요. 영수 에어가. I have another review for you on what I believe is going to make noise in the future. End of 2017, beginning of 2018. It's going to make some noise like Chuck D, all right? And Public Enemy. This is a beaut right here, and it's coming out of the house to Tiziana Terenzi. Have a gander at this friggin' red monstrosity right here. Boom. Absolute stunner. This fragrant journey begins now. Let's go. Alright people, welcome back. Yeah, in case you missed it, coming out of the house of Tiziana Terenzi, this is Porpora. And I have to tell ya, this is a really, really sexy ass fragrance. Now, for those of you that are not familiar with the presentation of this house's fragrances and bottles, I mean, there are several that they make. It's not just this one, and they actually come in different colors. This thing right here weighs like 15 pounds. It's heavy as hell. I'm exaggerating with the 15, but it's a heavy mother shut your mouth. Anyway, this is 100 mil. All right, and if you're interested in the presentation, this is the cap, which by the way, by itself weighs probably more than the bottle does. Really hard, man. I want to say that is it's probably aluminum. In matter of fact, it is aluminum. And if you have a gander at the top of this cap, it is showing various phases of the moon. So anyway, let's go ahead and jump into the fragrance, right? Before we get into anything, you know how I do. Let's jump first into the notes. Stand by.
Yeah.
1, 2,
hit it,
oh yeah,
black dragon,
that's right,
technique,
recognize,
no slip,
no doubt,
kung fu,
east side,
bring the bass in,
Orlando,
tap,
throw your hands up,
Chelsea
Mack,
throw your hands up,
everybody in the place,
throw your hands up,
I'm gonna go ahead and tell you right now that this fragrance is an XDP and it is a monster. In my experience, I don't know about the rest of you, but in my experience, most of the XDPs do not perform like XDPs. They perform more like EDTs, believe it or not. They last a wicked long time, but they're not beasts. This is a beast. Not only does it last, you know, a long, long time, but it jumps off the skin like friggin' kangaroos on pogo sticks. All right? Now, here's what happens when I spray it on my skin. Make no bones about it. This is a very, very jammy rose concoction. Jammy rose like you read about. All right? Here's what's going on with this. Soon as I spray it on my skin, I am literally blasted with a hardcore amount of raspberry and roses. Right out of the gate, boom. That's all you're gonna get. It is a rose raspberry bomb. Flippin' fantastic. Give this fragrance about maybe 35, 40 minutes. We'll say 30 to 40 minutes. Then it starts getting spicy, really spicy. You're talking cloves and cinnamon, all right? So now those flavors come together, all right? And then they start doing dances on your skin, okay? About another half hour to maybe 45 minutes later, then you're going to start getting a different type of rose. This rose is a Bulgarian variety. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know what the difference is between a regular rose and a Bulgarian rose. when the middle notes start to kick in, which, by the way, is where the Bulgarian rose is listed, in that tier, it starts to get sweeter. Now, there are no sweet notes in this fragrance whatsoever until you get to the very end of it when the amber starts to kick in. But it's more of a powdery sweet than a vanillary sweet type of amber. It's friggin' beautiful. Anyway, it reminds me of something Christmassy. I do not know why, but it does. It reminds me of something Christmas, and it might be because of what's next, which is the incense. All right? You're going to get incense in the middle of this fragrance, and it's going to come in not ridiculously hot and heavy, but you're definitely going to notice it. Then it starts to get a little bit skanky with the, earthy, not really hippie style, but very distinct patch or patchouli, if you're not up on the lingua franca. So I haven't sprayed this today, but just taking the cap off, I can smell it right from here. I can smell it, and it's just phenomenal. About another hour, and by the way, this is a very long-lasting fragrance. About another hour into this, then you're going to start to really get the Christmassy stuff, right? Chestnuts. Now, you may think, how's that possible? The chestnuts and the burning of the myrrh. I don't know, Nat King Cole maybe? Chestnuts roasting on an open fire? Couldn't tell you, but that's what I get from it. That's what it evokes for me. And then, again, once those bass notes kick in, again, you start getting the chestnuts and the burning of the myrrh. It starts getting musky, a tiny bit animalic. And then it also gets very resinous with the benzoin. So this, again, to keep it short and sweet, is a ridiculously jammy rose fragrance that's rounded out with smoke. Again, not a ridiculous amount, but we know when the incense and myrrh start to merge together, it makes it a little bit more smoky than you might think. Very soft amber, kind of on the powdery side a little bit. Those beautiful roasted chestnuts and that resinous benzoin. But again, like a lot of the fragrances, I mean, this by the way, this house is beginning to jump, like it's beginning to leapfrog to among my favorites. You guys already know I am a fanboy of Mancera, Montal, Profumum Roma, Armouage, and Zirjoff. This right here is coming up. All those other houses are looking in their rearview mirror because this is pumping out some really awesome poop. If you're not into, floral fragrances, jammy florals, then you're going to want to avoid this like the plague. But if you are into that type of stuff, then you probably should get your nose on this, sample it. It smells absolutely fantastic. Longevity is ridiculous. I really could not tell you how long it lasts because when I put it on my skin, by the time I had to take a shower to change fragrances or whatever, it was still hot and heavy. So I have no idea how long it lasts specifically. But what I can tell you is when I wore it to work the other day, it was going seriously strong after 11 hours and it showed no signs of letting up. Then I had to take a shower and go out to dinner. But holy friggin' sweet mother of God. Again, captivating. I cannot even begin to describe to you how absolutely, just beautiful. I am not really sure why, but this fragrance to me is a little bit darker than the notes would leave you to believe. I mean, other than obviously the smoke. But man, it's a really dark fragrance, I think. And it might be because, like I said, of the smoke and maybe to a lesser extent the patchouli. But it really reminds me of it's weird because although roses are considered, a warm weather type of floral, it reminds me of like a cold, dark evening in Massachusetts when there's like a foot of snow on the ground, which is why I left there, by the way, because F that, don't care about snow and cold anymore, can't deal with it, I'm done. But that's what it kind of reminds me of, like, Christmas Eve with a ton of snow on the ground. It's cold as hell, and the smells emanating from people's homes when they're making spicy foods, and I don't know. I mean, it's weird to me. It's hard to explain, but But that's what it kind of reminds me of, even though it shouldn't, because it's supposed to be a summer type of fragrance, I guess, but it doesn't remind me of that at all. It reminds me more of winter, which, you know, again, I don't live there anymore. As you guys know, I relocated. I can't stand cold and snow, but that's what it reminds me of. And by the way, because it does, it's very nostalgic in that, you know, it reminds me of being there when my family, you know, we all lived together, because my family's huge, but we all obviously went away and did our own thing. But it reminds me of being, you know, in the family, having, you know, dinner together on cold nights. I don't know. It's weird. It shouldn't remind me of that, but it does. Whatever. Bottom line, though, is it smells absolutely fantastic. It's so friggin' captivating. It's like you can't stop smelling yourself. It's that friggin' good. And that's it, man. You know, it's not that, you know, I don't have to give you a long 90-minute, you know, dissertation on what it smells like. You got it. That's it. So, yeah. Spicy, jammy rose lovers, take note. This is going to knock your socks off. That's my opinion. It knocked mine off. I'm still trying to find them. Anyway, in case you missed it, from the house of Tiziana Terenzi, Porpora. I'm done. My next review is soon. I'll talk to you guys later.